Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another episode of Let's Build. In today's episode, we're going to create a prototype model of our character that we've conceptualized in the previous video. The reason why we're doing a prototype is because we need a general idea of how the character will feel inside of a production space. So a prototype character does not require all of the details, it doesn't necessarily need a lot of the texturing. The purpose of a prototype character is just to get some R&D information. So we still are in the research and development phase. By doing this character in a very simple format with simple rigging, we can get a general gist of what is going to be, what will work and what will not work later on. So let's just go ahead and continue to explore. Now in the previous video, we were doing some of the concept art. You can see that the character looks pretty good, okay? We've got a little bit of shading. We have a general idea of what direction we want this character to go in, but we don't actually have to stick necessarily with the concept that we have here. Remember, this is just the first concept. We have the general gist right up here. We can alter the concept of the character inside of ZBrush, because ZBrush is really good to do some very quick rough conceptualization of your character, especially if they're very organic. But in Maya, we can use the traditional method. We're just going to start with a low poly mesh and then add some details on it. So let's go ahead and begin with a very simple shaping of the mesh. So I'm going to start with what's called a mirror cube. Now a mirror cube, by default, you just go ahead and create a square. I'm going to turn the subdivisions to 2 or 4, I should say. Okay, to 4. So that's our mirror cube. Well, not yet. I'm going to lock it to the origin right here. Let's go to component mode, delete one side of all of the faces so we only have half a cube. Okay. That way, when we go to something like edit and then we duplicate, so let's go duplicate special to the options box. We're going to create an instance, make sure it's a parent, and make sure the scale is -1 and then apply. Now that you have a mirror cube, you have two separate objects that make up a cube, you can go into component mode and then start modeling, okay? This is the most common method to do it, to do modeling the traditional way. So this is what we're going to do. We're going to use this mirror cube right now and start shaping it based on the silhouette of this character, okay? So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to go to the front view. Let's just move this up so that we have a better view of that. And for Maya, this is the image that we have here. I'm going to go and just reduce the opacity a bit, because I don't feel that I need to have the opacity up. Whoops. So let's go here. It's a bit hard to make it work, but that's alright. Alright, so what we have here is the model. Let's go to the vertex mode. And you can see you can go between the front or the perspective view. The reason why I don't have a profile view is because I don't feel like I need it. I can get a general gist of that. And we can do that a little bit later as well when it comes to the concepts. But because this is a prototype, we're only doing some basics. Okay, so I'm going to separate that into different spaces right here. So I'm going to make sure this is... That's actually the piece over here. Up here, we'll move this down. And we're just going to get a feel of that character's silhouette, okay? Down here as well, I'm going to go all the way down. And same as before, we're going to just shape it up until we get a general silhouette of this character. So it's not that hard, it's quite simple. Now if you're starting out modeling and you're not sure what to do, that's totally fine. Don't worry too much about that. The idea here is to keep it very simple, because later on I will create a much better I'll have another tutorial that will focus on making sure we have a good result. So this is the profile view or the side view. We're going to just shrink it a bit. Okay. I probably should have started with fewer divisions, because it feels like I've gone a little bit too overboard with that. The top one is like that. Just going to make it a little bit smaller. Okay, and then we're moving these individual vertices until we get a good silhouette of the character. You can see that the back is looking quite nice now. Okay, I'm just going to keep... I'll keep this in the perspective mode so that you can see what I'm trying to do, what I'm trying to achieve. Okay, that's good. The traditional method, you can see, is not that hard. It's pretty, you're pretty much just trying to sculpt or carve out a piece of wood almost. But that's probably not the best, most accurate way of describing what Maya is, or the traditional modeling method. And another thing about the traditional modeling method is that it is a little bit obsolete these days, because you have sculpting tools. Sculpting tools are fantastic for organic characters, because it allows you to focus only on the art form, what it looks like, rather than worry about the technicalities. When you're doing the traditional method, you are actually worrying about the technical aspects of this. So we're trying to make sure we focus only on the artwork, the art style, especially when we get to the modeling stages. But right now, this is just a prototype. We're not focusing on getting it perfect. All we really want is just something to work with, okay, to begin with. And I think I might have messed up a bit here. I don't feel that I should have used this that many subdivisions, so. But that's all right. Alright, so that's the character's profile. And if you probably would have noticed that there is a slight curve with the character's silhouette on the profile side here. So the legs, or the bottom of his tail, I should say, sort of angled, curved in this direction. That's the sort of the mode that I'm trying to go for. Okay. Same with the top of the head as well. So we do that. This is not that great, this model, this mesh, so, but that's all right. I'm not worried about that for now. And then we'll go to the top and then just try to smooth these edges out. So I'm going to use a soft select by holding B and then middle mouse drag. And all I'm really doing is trying to get that nice curve on our character's body. So I want to make sure I don't get the middle of that character's body right there. So let's go ahead and do this side now. And in terms of the front side of things, I do need to make sure there is a bit more room here, because I want the eyes to be somewhat angled out. That's okay. Now, that's not perfect. That's certainly a little bit messed up right here, but let's go ahead and fix that. I'm going to go to my normals, and then I'm just going to soften the edge so that I get a better read on that silhouette right there. But you kind of get the point, right? You kind of get the point of where we're trying to go. Let's go and use the what's called split polygon tool, I should say, sorry. And what I'm going to do is just try and smooth out some of this topology, because it's looking a little bit ugly right now. So just click here, and then we split like that, okay. And then from here we can smooth out any edges that we don't actually like. So this is another edge here that we don't like. And you don't want to add too many polygons right now, just because you are doing this the traditional way, which means you have to move the vertices almost one at a time. That's why you don't want to add too much detail, because it's going to be crazy trying to add it. And then I'm going to go back to my split polygon like this. Very simple. And then just play around with the topology. Now, I'm not worried about that topology, like I said before. All I want is a general shape of this character. Let's remove this edge here, because we don't really need it. And then I'm going to go back to my split polygon tool, and then probably just finish that up here. So that this is also known as a pole. I want to avoid that when it comes to things like, things like that, really. And then we also want to remove any n-gons, so I might be able to split the polygons in this direction. Like that, down here, bang. Remove the edge. Adjust the vertex, go back to your split polygon tool, and then try and get a nice clean mesh. As best as you can, okay? This is probably not a very clean mesh, so I'm going to go ahead and remove that one. And what I want to do is try and find a way to smooth that out a bit. Same with the eyes here, so the eyes are going to be here. But I want this to have some kind of a pointed nose. just a little bit more of a pointed nose like that. Let's go back to our split polygon tool. And you can do this in any, just about any software package. You don't have to stick with Maya. You don't have to use what I'm using. 3D software these days, they do just about everything the same way. Okay, so that's how you do very traditional modeling method. Like I said, this is not going to be that great a result because I am going really fast. I also want to play with this. So just make sure the X is at zero. So that's quite smooth. Let's fix the bottom one down here. The bottom one is pretty bad. So let's go ahead and adjust. We will adjust the vertices like that. Till we get a nice good result. Okay, so it's the same deal before. You want to make sure the edges look, or the edge topology is good. Otherwise you get all kinds of weird issues later on, especially when it comes to rigging. So here's the split polygon tool, and you kind of get the idea, okay? We're not going to spend too much time on this because this is just a prototype and it doesn't have to have any features on. All it really needs is just a general silhouette so that you can get a feel of it in action, on the field, I should say. Okay, so that's the, this is the traditional method, and we'll move on to ZBrush right about now. Because I'm about to leave this right here. You can also use the sculpt tool, sculpt geometry, to smooth out anything. Something like that. Just makes it a bit easier for you to work with. Something like that. Which is pretty nice. It's a good tool to use. Smooths out the polygons around the body here. Okay, it's getting torn apart down here, but I'm not worried. I'm going to soften the edges. And then over here, let's just go ahead and, well, we're going to merge it in a bit. Down here, let's fix up the topology and then we'll stop right there, okay? So down here, we're going to go. And you want to, again, avoid poles as much as you can, but just remember that we don't really care at this stage. Okay. And then we will stop it right there. That's pretty good. Okay, so that's got a nice, good silhouette to the character. There might be a few things we can play around with, but for now, that's good enough for me to work with. Let's go ahead and merge the two layers together. So I'm going to go combine. So let's go ahead and combine. I'm going to go Shift I to isolate. And what I want to do is merge the edges of this. So you can see that the edges are here. And the reason why I do this manually is because sometimes there are mistakes that I probably didn't catch, okay, during the production stage. But I'm going really fast, so I'm not trying to be super accurate. We don't really care about that, any mistakes that we have right now. All we want to do is just get a shape in, have a feel, have a play around, hope for the best. So down here we've got more shaping. Okay, and that's about it. So that's the character. What I'm going to do is smooth the edges, soften the edges. So now you have the feel of the character. We can go ahead and use the sculpt geometry if you want and just smooth out parts of the body like so. Actually, I should have done that as a mirror, so. Let's go ahead and save this. Sculpt geometry. I'm going to make sure I have a mirror. So I'm looking for mirror on the other side. I can't actually find it. So it might be here. Here we go. Reflection. And we'll want the reflection axes to be on the x-axis, I believe. Yep. And we just smooth that out a little bit. Okay. Sculpting tools inside of other programs can be very useful. Okay. So you may not actually need to use the actual, well, you may not actually need to use the tools inside of Maya. You can just go ahead and use it inside of ZBrush or something. So that's the shape. We're going to call this Tillion. Alright, in terms of height, we also have to take that into account. Now remember, I want this character to have at least, I want this character to be about a meter high. So let's just count this down here. We've got five, each cube or each square down here is 1 centimeter. So I'm going to count 5, 10. So we've got 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So he's 50 centimeters here. 60, 70, 80, 90. I'll probably just scale him up like 200%. So scale up by 2 like that, and that's our model. Don't forget to freeze the transformations. We want it to be at 0 because later on it can be very useful to work with. The origin is also looking good. Okay. All right. That's basically it. Let's add some very simple skeleton or joints. So we start with one joint here. 1, 2, 3. Actually, I'll probably make it a bit easier. So just 2 joints like that. Okay. And then another one joint. 1, 2. Okay. Whoops. Now let me go ahead and play with the radius, so we can see it a bit better. And because I'm not too worried about the, I'm just going to x-ray joints, because I'm not too worried about the rigging system, I'm going to leave it at that. We can go ahead and add a couple of circles or a couple of spheres here for the hand. All right. Translate X is going, I'm just duplicating and then moving it to the side. And then we're going to turn the subdivision down to like, I don't know, 10. Okay, do the same here. Duplicate that again, move it to the side, and then smooth or soften the edges. Now there's no UV map on this, so we might as well create one right now since we're here. So all I'm gonna do is go to my UV, well, let's go create UVs and then planar mapping. And then I'm also going to go to window, UV texture editor. I'm just going to turn the shading on, and all I want to do is just do some very basic shading. Okay, so we've got the hands, the hand UV shell, and then we've got this one. So for those who don't know how to do UV mapping is like creating, or well, it's basically you taking the t-shirt on your that you are wearing and then pulling all the threads out and then laying the pieces out on the floor. That's what UV mapping is, except we actually have to create the seams. So in our case, we have to think about how we want this character to look in terms of texture. Because this character is going to be quite front on, we don't want any seams down here. So we're going to create some seams by just go to edge, and all I'm going to do is just select it from the back. Okay, so we have the seams, well, the seam attached here, but I want the face, or at least the front part of the character, to remain unchanged. So let's go ahead and cut. So go to our UV texture editor, cut. Let's display the edges. And then from here, we're going to get the computer to lay it out for us, okay, on the floor right here. So we go to polygons, unfold, just make sure you are pin selected UVs, okay, so that's good. And then we just go ahead and apply, and what you get is a very simple layout of the, well, of the character right here. Okay, so that's very simple. We're not going to worry about distortion at this stage because it doesn't really matter. This is just a prototype. Okay, so what really matters, the only thing that matters, is to make sure that you have the UVs laid out, because we're going to experiment with a little bit of with some of the materials inside of Unreal Engine. Okay, just make sure that's already clear. Okay, another thing is I do want to remove this thing, so off, don't want to see that in my scene or in my perspective view. All right, let's go ahead and select the mesh, select the bones. We're going to skin and then smooth bind. Reason why we smooth bind is because it just gives us a bit more, well, makes it a little bit easier. Actually, I'm going to redo that. So I'm going to select the torso only and then smooth bind. Okay, and then we can play around with the tail. Probably doesn't have enough polygons to work with, but again, we don't really care. And then from here, we'll just go and add influence. So, whoops. Not add influence, I should go to rigid bind. And then let me go ahead and paint the material weights, paint the weights very quickly, because I want to be able to at least do something. Okay, I think that's actually pretty good, so don't have to worry too much about that. And just to make things a bit easier for me, what I'm going to... Actually, no, you know what? I'll leave that as it is. This is done. Let's just go ahead and import this into our Unreal Engine. Okay, so we go to File, Export, wherever that is, Export. We'll go Export Selection. Oh, one other thing is you want to make sure that the... everything is grouped up. Okay, so this is mesh. I'm going to delete that group. Tillion joint. Oops. Okay. All right, let's go and export. Export selection. We're going to export as an FBX. Now you need to make sure you have FBX 2012 and or later. Otherwise, it's not going to work. I believe it's 2012. I'm not 100% sure. I gotta double check on that, but let me go ahead and actually, let's just go and export all. That might be a bit easier. So Project Ignisol, Tillion prototype 01. All right, we don't have any animation, so I'm gonna leave that off. I'm going to triangulate it, but really you should be triangulating it yourself, so it doesn't really matter. We'll leave that as it is. Smooth mesh, tangent bind normals, split vertex normals, that's perfect. And then we just go ahead and export. Oh, 2013, I believe, sorry, 2013. Okay, let's go into our Unreal Engine. All right, so once we've got Unreal Engine ready, we're going to drag that FBX file into our Unreal Engine project here. We're just going to import all, and that is our mesh right here. So that's our mesh. You can see that the character is looking pretty good. He's about a meter high, which is perfect because that's the size I want this character to be. You can change it, of course, but for now this is pretty good. And then we've got starter content here already, so let me first of all create a folder. I'm gonna go and just right click new folder. We're going to call it Ignisol. And in here, we will create another folder called prototype. All right, from here, I actually want to grab all of the content that we've imported, just put it into that prototype right there. So we move it, and you can see that we have the character ready to go, okay? So I'm going to duplicate this character. And we can actually start using this mesh right now to inside of a third person kind of a thing, and then maybe add some basic animations. We're not going to do that. Let's go ahead and take a look at some of the materials before we go back and tighten this character out. Okay, we just want to add a few more features on this character so that we get something that looks a bit better than just a block of what you see right there. I'm going to grab a material that we already have somewhere here. I'm just looking for something that looks good or close to the material that I'm after. So let's try metal chrome, okay, or metal gold. I'm going to let that compile the shader very quickly, and that in and of itself will give us a very good idea. I'm going to hold L and create a light. This light is going to be what I will use to just light this character and get an idea of whether or not the character is working. Okay, so you can see that the material is looking great. And remember that seam we had in the back? Well, it shows up here, just over here. It's a bit hard to see, but you can see the seam. That's one of the reasons why you want to try and cover up the scenes with other features on this character as well. But you also have to take that into account with materials. This is looking pretty good. You can use other materials that are available in the marketplace, for example, if you wanted to use like a Well, obsidian texture, just go to the marketplace, find someone with an obsidian texture, and then go from there. But right now, this is looking really, really nice. You can see that the reflections of that material is looking good. We have a basic idea of what the character looks like right now. Okay, so this is perfect. I'm actually quite pleased with that. So that's what a Tilian is going to look like. This not as shiny, but we're going to play around with the material a bit later. You can also do that right now. Just double click and then start trying to maybe add other features, maybe like a metallic, or actually we've got a metallic constant with a constant of one. So, but we can also play with this constant here, so we can make it a little bit darker like that. Okay, which will probably make it a little bit nicer, least with what we want to do. We take a look and see where the multiplier is going into, which is there, and that's fine. That's the texture of the material. I'm going to add a function called an overlay, so blend overlay. So we put this in. We'll have the result. And what I'm going to do is create a constant and see if we can get a darker color. Hopefully we will. I'm not too sure how that works. Yeah, we will, sort of. Let's just bring this up a little bit. I might make this a three vector. So hold three and then click. This allows us to get a color. So three vector may be nice, and then we might give it like a slightly red tinge like that. And then see how the update, well, see what it looks like when it updates. And this might give us some idea as to where we want to go with our character's material. So you can see Unreal Engine's material editor is very powerful. You have a lot of control. If you use other game engines, for example, CryEngine or Unity or perhaps even Source Engine, there are going to be limitations. These limitations is something you need to be aware of. Otherwise, your art style that you want to go for may not be possible. So that's something you have to take into account. Okay, we have roughness, of course, and that's actually not too bad. So let's just go ahead and save that. Let it compile, and then we'll move on to the slightly more complicated part of modeling, and then we'll bring that model in. Okay, so compiling the shaders. Actually, there's a lot of shaders that need to be compiled, which is a bit frustrating. But you can see that the thing here is quite nice. I'm just going to create another light and then change this light to maybe a red. This might give us, or even an orange. This will give us a re like an interesting result. So that's sort of what the character looks like right now. Okay, it's quite interesting. The other thing is distortion. I've already talked about that inside of UVs. That's one reason why you want to make sure your UVs are as smooth as possible. You want to reduce the amount of distortion. We don't care about that at this stage, so let's focus on getting the model, or the basic model, right. And don't throw away the mesh that you have created, because we can actually reuse that later, especially if we need to reconceptualize our character. Okay, so let's just leave that as it is. Right now, this character is looking great. In another episode, I will actually start creating a third person system so that you can play around with the character. And then once we have the third person system in, we can begin creating, well, tightening up the character's details. Okay, not we're still in the R&D session right now. All right, so don't worry too much about finalizing things. I'm going to go ahead and just save this and then close this off. All right, first thing we need to do is go back into our original project, and we are going to export that mesh as an OBJ. So let's go ahead, OBJ, export the selection, OBJ export, and then export it into the Ignisol. So we'll call it Tilian prototype. We don't want the FBX there, so let's go ahead and save that. And that's basically it. All right, inside of ZBrush, don't feel too discouraged if you don't know how to use ZBrush. You don't have to use ZBrush. This is just something I want to cover because some people do use it. We're going to import this, so let's go ahead and import. I'm gonna go to my Ignisol folder right here, and whoops, my apologies, into the other folder, and then we're just going to import this particular mesh. So you can see that this is the mesh that we've created inside of Unreal Engine. Let's press T to go to edit mode, and then we can start modeling this character. Okay, I'm also going to save it. So project, let's build, let's call this the Tilian prototype. This will change, by the way. All right, and also want this to rotate on the y-axis. Let's go ahead and go to perspective mode, and then we can start modeling this out. So to add some divisions, we just press D. If you want to go down, you press Shift D. Okay, so D is really useful. Control D, sorry, not D. I'm getting that wrong. Okay, and I'm going to turn lazy mouse off because I want to be able to model this myself. Let's just add a couple more subdivisions and then we'll start sculpting. So when you're sculpting, oh, I'm getting a bit mixed up with my thing here. So I'm going to go to BCB, which is the clay brush. This allows me a bit more control. Okay. And also want to turn the intensity down. I don't want it to be too high. Can add another division as well, just to get it working as best as we can. So what I want to do is start carving out or playing around with the character's topology. As before, we've already got a low poly mesh, but that's the traditional method. This is the more modern method, and what we're doing is I'm going to actually shift down, and then you can hold shift, you can add some volume, you can reduce some volume, as long as the character's silhouette is good. That's kind of what we're aiming for. I'm going to go BD, which is, oops, sorry, no. I'm going to go to the BT, which is the trim, and then we're going to go to dynamic. So trim dynamic. This allows me to flatten out the mesh, so something like that, which is kind of what we want. I also want to maintain the mesh's appearance, so let's go ahead and do that. Let's just shave off some detail. And this allows me to get some really nice organic results for this character, because this character is quite organic. I'm going to go back to my clay brush, add a little bit of volume here. And you can see that even though we haven't gotten anything looking too well, we don't have any details here. You can see that it's actually, you can see that it's looking pretty good already just by adding that extra detail. Just going to add some extra lazy steps so that we model a bit quicker. And I'm going to trim the dynamic feel here. I'm also going to go down one level and just delete the highest subdivision right now. So we'll go to geometry. Let's delete higher. And we'll just focus on making these organic details, because this is a very chrysalistic type of a character. Okay, I'm going to remove that bottom bit here. So we have a bit of a point that we can go down towards, which is quite nice. Okay. You can also inflate BI and F, I believe. Inflate wherever that is. N. So BIN. You can inflate it in case you've lost too much volume. And then just go back to the trim and then try and get something that you like. And this is the fun part about doing it inside a sculpting tool. A sculpting tool allows you to conceptualize and model at the same time. So now we have some of these organic little shapes here. There's a bit of issue with the topology, but that was the issue that I had to fix a while back. But you can see that we can create some of these grills or gills. And this is going to be really good because now we can, I'm just going to squash this up a little bit. Because now we can at least get a more organic feel of this particular character. Okay. And modeling a character like this is not going to be too hard. So let's go ahead and shrink this brush. And we're nearing the end of this episode, so let's go lickety-split. I'm going to go back to my trim dynamic and just trim this particular segment off here. Now, if you want, we can go ahead and add some eyes. Let me just go and fix up these subdivisions. I'll actually use a Z remesher, so I'm going to remesh that. Let ZBrush remesh this for you so that we get it's easier for us to actually model. You can see you can get some really nice details here right now, but we'll start with broad strokes first. Hold Alt to do the opposite, okay, if that's what you are after. Okay, and then we've got some really nice details happening here. So we're not following the concept right now, we're just creating our own, but you can already see what is possible with something like this. So We'll just add some organic gills. And don't forget, over here is going to be like a circle for the arm, so let's go ahead and add that in. Just remember that you are modeling on the other side as well, so let's go to trim dynamics. So we trim. I'm going to add another subdivision. Okay, so that's looking quite nice. Let me go back to my clay brush and play around with something. Some of that right here. And don't worry too much about the topology or how you want it to look, because you are going to be able to change it or use... Actually, no, that's too far down. I went too far, that's my bad. Let me just fix this up again. And then the trim dynamic, I'm going to trim the inside of that. Just a bit, just a tad. Okay. Which is good. Add some volume here. I'm gonna run into like some issues, but remember, we're not worried about the topology, we're just trying to get a good feel, a good vibe of the character's look and feel, the general shape. So that's not too bad. I'm just going to smooth that area down, because I don't want him to have too many organic parts. I want him to be quite smooth, quite organized. And up the top here, what I'm going to do is just add a little bit of a helmet kind of a element. Okay. And we'll use the dynamic trim. Expand the size of that, otherwise I'm not going to be able to get anything right. And down here, just make sure it's looking good. So the silhouette of the character can also help distinguish different characters between each other. That's what we're doing here. And then over here we can, I don't know, play around with some of the tiny details. Okay, so that's looking good. Let's just go ahead and add a couple more subdivisions, and what I'm going to do is start adding tiny, tiny details here, because remember, Unreal Engine is capable of a lot. We don't have to stick with too little of a brush. Okay, I'm just going to shrink this a little bit, and what I want to do is add a couple of eyes here. Just a little bit of indentation, and then the mouth is obviously going to be here. Okay, so that's kind of a good idea of what our character is going to look like right now. I didn't actually bring the arm, that's actually my fault. But not too bad. Let's go ahead and use Z remesher. Okay. Reconstruct the subdivisions. I'm just going to lower the resolution right now so that we have a nice, good feel of this character's eyes. Okay, I'm going to delete the lower resolution, and then we'll add some extra features here. So, BMV, we're going to model the mouth a little bit like that. And I feel that the front is a little bit too organic, so I'm going to flatten parts of his body in the front. I want his front to be quite smooth, like that. Same up the top here. Okay. And let's go to Dynamesh. You can also use Dynamesh to create cuts in your character. So if we go to Dynamesh right now, Dynamesh is something I probably should have started with, but that's all right. And what I'm going to do is trim lasso. So I'm going to, trim. So what I want to do is trim, something like that. Okay, this gives me a nice result, same deal here. I'm actually not happy with that front one, so I'm just going to trim the back like that. I also want to, turn off my perspective mode. Okay, so that way it's easier for me to trim. And then I'll do the same here. Down here as well. So I want some sharp edges on this character. So using the trim tool is really great because you can get some nice cuts in our character. Okay, so we are focusing on the just making sure that the character looks good, okay, art-wise. So we have a little bit of a nose right there, and then we're going to get the silhouette out like that. Okay. The other thing is I don't want him to look like an elf, so I'm probably going to have to fix that later. I'm going to change the resolution, just make it a little bit larger, bigger. Use the trim brush now. Trim dynamic. I'm just going to smooth out parts of our character's body. And then we're going to let the dynamic mesh fix that up. And then we'll use Z-remesher to redo that as well. So I apologize. I was supposed to use Dynamesh first before I started doing anything else. But I kind of messed that up. So that's fine. So Dynamesh is really good for us to get good results without worrying about topology first, because topology is quite easy to fix using these extra tools here. So let me go ahead and use, just delineate that eyelid. That eyebrow. Okay, so that eye is looking good. I don't really want this character to have a nose, so I'm going to keep that flat because that's kind of part of the appeal. Remember, this character is going to be made up of light in general. So another thing you have to take into account whenever you're modeling a character like this. So, but this character is looking quite nice right now. I'm pretty happy with how he looks. I do want to change parts of his topology. Okay, so and over here, just add some extra volume. It's actually not that great doing it this way. And then we'll flatten that out as best as we can. Okay. So, looks good. Looks great. Pretty happy with this character, at least the direction he's going. Down the bottom here, we're going to fix up something. So, let's go ahead and do that. And I'll show you how to bring this character back inside of Maya. Okay, it's just for final detailing, generally. But this is just a prototype. Remember, we don't care about the perfection of this character. All we want is just to get an idea of how the character is going to look like in a practical level, in a production level. And if it doesn't look good, then you'll have to go to the drawing board, because sometimes even a concept art may not be enough. Sometimes it's a little bit tricky to read, so. Okay, so that's looking pretty good. I love the silhouette, actually. The silhouette looks really nice. Here, I want to add some blending detail. Okay, so maybe we'll go all the way down. And this character will be a bit different when we get into the swing of things. Alright, we're pretty much at the end of this episode, guys. Just remember, you are capable of doing this as long as the project is within the scope of your abilities. You are more than capable. The hardest part is usually motivation, so don't worry too much about motivation. Just have fun while you're doing this, okay? Because we are going to mess up some things as we go through this journey. This is going to be a 24-month journey. 2 years to create something really, really good. Something you can do in your free time. And you can see that in an hour, I've been able to create some pretty detailed characters right now. Okay, so... And try not to stress too much about it. The idea here is just to make sure you have fun. This is a Tillian looking pretty badass right now. So I'm quite happy with how this character is looking. Might have to adjust some of that. So that's done. Let me go ahead and just save this out. And then I'm going to use Z-Remesher. And what I'm going to do is target poly count, so probably about 2,000. Let's say 4,000 and let ZBrush retopologize this character for you. Later on, if you're going to make a video game out of this, you'll probably have to create your low poly mesh manually, which I will show you inside of ZBrush in a later episode. For now, this is pretty much done. We're going to stop it right here. Okay, so this is about 10,000 polygons. Honestly, I really don't care about the polygon count. I'm going to export this out. Let's just go ahead. High mesh 01. Okay. What I'm going to do is bring that object, OBJ, into Maya. I'm going to delete this one. And that's our mesh right here. This was created inside of ZBrush. It's a little bit too small. I'm just going to increase the size of him. Okay. And remember, we don't care about how well the character is going to look. Okay, all we really care about is just a general, just to get a general idea of what the character looks like. I need to double check my UV shells if I can remember where I've put that editor. Okay, I've actually lost my UV, so I'm going to create the UVs again. Okay, same deal as before. This has way more polygons than we really need. And all I'm going to do is just cut the back like so. I've got some of the front bits and I don't really want that. Okay, and that's it. And then go back to my UV editor. Let's go ahead and cut it. Cut. Done. And then, of course, I'm just going to grab two UVs from the front and let it unfold, okay? So it takes a while because we've got a lot more volume. But that's pretty much it. Okay. Let's go ahead and create the skin. So we smooth bind it. And we're done. Alright, so now we can somewhat animate a character. Actually, I'll remove that. Let me go ahead and freeze the transformations first. Let's go back to skin, bind skin. I'm going to go to the options of smooth bind and let's reset the settings and then just apply. Oops, we need to select the bone as well and apply. And now we have something that's a little bit smoother. Okay, not that it matters right now, but it's something that we can stick around and use. Gonna move that mesh into the Tillian joint right here, which is done. And then let's go ahead and export all into the same FBX, and we can go into Unreal Engine and then just take a look at the character right now. Okay, so this is our project. This is the previous model, the mesh that we have. I'm gonna go back to my folder here and let me go ahead and right click and then re-import. So basically we're just refreshing what we've already saved. And you can see this is the character right now, much nicer, much better. Whoops. Of course, we need to play around with some of the other settings, but that's okay for the moment. Let's just go ahead and just look at, see what this character is capable of. Okay, in terms of materials, we are getting a good idea or a good read of our character right now. I'm quite happy with that. Okay. So you can see that Unreal Engine has really nice material shading. Especially if they're very metallic, so it's kind of what the character looks like here. And I'm quite happy with that right now. This is not the... Well, this is just a prototype, of course, but we can create a third-person test of this character so that we can play around with. So, for example, the the feel, the look of the character. This is way too many polygons for what we want, but at least we've got a nice silhouette right now. In terms of poly count, when it comes to your characters inside of a game engine like Unreal Engine, you don't have to worry about that too much these days. 100,000 polygons is probably a count that you want to aim for high-end characters. You can go up as high as 150,000 or 200,000. That's up to you. That also depends on the character's design and how you want the character to read inside of a game. The general rule applies. You want to avoid as... you want to get the best silhouette with the fewest amount of polygons as you possibly can. There are other things that we can talk about later. For example, level of detail or tessellation, for example. So that's not relevant right now. We're just going to focus on R&D. At this stage, I'm pretty happy with where it's going. We are going to continue to do more R&D, and we're going to adjust based on what we discover, okay? So for now, I'm giving this a thumbs up. This may or may not have worked for you, which is totally fine if your character, if you feel that the character isn't going to work or whatever that may be. That's okay. The idea here is to get some information. You just need data on how the character is working for you, okay, inside the scene. Because for example, if the character design doesn't look good in a crowd, if I were to have like a crowd system, then you're going to have to go back to the drawing board and then test your idea out again on paper, okay, or in Photoshop in that case. So that's something you need to think about. That's okay, we're doing quite well. This is not too bad. I might try like a grass texture and see how that character looks, but all in all, pretty happy. In 1 hour you can do some very quick R&D. R&D is really important, as I've been trying to emphasize. It helps you establish what can and cannot be done before you begin working on the project itself. Okay, so we are going to move into later, well, in the later stages, we're going to move into more complicated things. For example, we'll move into things like what we're talking about, high resolution characters, okay, for example. That's going to change the way you model, that's going to change the way you conceptualize your characters, but for now, this is pretty good. Okay guys, I will leave that for you. Thank you so much for watching. As always, please subscribe. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the comment section below. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Good luck on your project. Have fun. Don't worry about making mistakes right now. This is kind of the point of R&D, is to make as many mistakes as you can so that you can learn from your mistakes, okay? You'll be fine. Catch up with you soon. I'll see you in the next episode.